Number one was more of that like raw sliced mushroom, moss, like mossiness, edamame, that kind of thing. Number two was actually really interesting because it was like sweet grass and like dew. You know, it's very subtle but pretty.
For me, number one was very delicate. I got maybe some magnolia on the palate, maybe some muddled basil.
And died down, but you're getting less of it. It's more faint. And then this Lure tea, it's off on its own. This seems to be completely different. It's more textured. It even has a little bit of a tannic grip where you actually feel astringency on your, you know, between your tongue. And
but I'm an aromatics guy. Like for me, 60% of the value of a wine is in its aromatics. I just always been my favorite part. So anytime you have teas that are very aromatic, I'm all over it. Number two for me, like it's probably the winner. It did have more of that lychee, almost like pineapple, white peach, underripe pear, kind of quality to it. I just thought it had a little more complexity, a little more elegance and silkiness, and overall, like everything worked.
You know, taking it to wine, the wines that I really love are really delicate and have good mouthfeel at the same time. And I think this is exactly what happened, and I picked up on that sweetness too. There was something about it, like all the way through. And you know, really, I didn't even put any specific, you know, flavors down for the palate. I was just really taken by, you know, the silkiness of it, how it expanded, you know, just enough. And then really, it just seemed to extend longer than any of them.
In terms of how to describe tea, and maybe a little bit from the wide world of tea, from what's freshest to oldest to culture to agriculture, yeah?
I got like fresh pumpkin.
Yeah, it's been exchanged with a lot of
series. I call it the PVT, the perfume vapor trail.
Yeah.
Strange.